step over here, sir, right at the end of the counter here.
I had the opportunity of speaking to a young man carrying out a bag of clothes with him. He was homeless. His family had given up on him totally. I shook his hand. I wished him the best. I had the opportunity of doing something for that individual, and I didn't do it.
It was April of 2018 when I had a call from Stan Kajawa. He was telling me about the experience of the jail with the addiction people leaving there and they come back in like a roving door, and thinking about the children mentoring program. And at that being, we brought up, well, maybe an adult mentoring program would work. Get this community behind it and create a program. And then we came up with a name and we called it Welcome to a New Life.
20 years ago, he would bring his crew up here. He great big grills, and he'd bring them in and feed the inmates. He'd say, you know, what can we do with different things? I always remember us saying, people going out the back door here, somebody needs to catch them and lead them the right direction.
All right, sir, right through these doors, we'll get you out of here today. Do you have somebody coming to pick you up?
I don't think so.
Do you know where you're going?
One of the things that has impressed me is how well that Welcome to New Life works alongside the other nonprofits. They all have their part, and just working together to fill the needs of someone that can can walk out of the jail with no concept really of what those resources are.
Welcome to New Life was started with a wonderful vision and mission, and that was to help individuals who are part of the criminal justice system get connected with wonderful mentors, volunteer mentors that will come alongside them, be that guidance, support, accountability partner, that friend that people need to just be by their side when things are not going well, or also be with them when to celebrate those moments and milestones in their life as they are accomplishing things, reducing some of those barriers. What's beautiful about this is to see that. It's to see how the growth of relationship has worked with mentors and mentees, and to see that life change.
I battled with drug addiction my entire life. I'm smoking weed, cocaine, been in and out of jail over 50 times. It was a repetitive type thing. I got a felony in 2019. That's when I came into Welcome to a New Life. It was a good accountability for me to have somebody there. I was like, hey, have you called your PO? Hey, have you gone to see your PO? Hey, have you done this? And the basic things that I just didn't do. I love telling the story of after I've gotten clean, what my life is like. I'm very active in the recovery field. I work as a housing coordinator at a sober living. I live with my mom and my daughter. We all have a house together. I'm very active in my family, where I couldn't be before. Recovery is something that I have to work at every day. I can't ever kind of put my guard down because addiction is hand in hand with recovery. If I'm not working on my recovery, I'm working on my relapse.
It's been a real honor to be a part of watching this grow into a real viable, workable organization in Findlay and Hancock County, and one that also partners with a lot of other organizations.
Welcome to a New Life has so many wonderful stories to share, but today I'd like to share the one about Wesley.
My initial surgeries and opiate experiences started when I had a knee surgery from football injury, and that doctor prescribed Percocet. This was 2008, so opiate addiction and epidemic was definitely, it was on fire then, but parents weren't really, they weren't hip to it, I guess. And my Percocet got left out, and I found out that if you take two, they make you feel a little bit better than just one, and then it was three, and I was able to get off of it in high school, but after my stomach surgery, it took a foot of intestines out, Dilaudid and Oxycontin for months and months, and then, yeah, it got pretty bad. I personally got involved with Welcome to a New Life when I got home from a men's mission program in Florida. When I got home, my mom had recommended that I follow up with this program, and I had met Carla Benjamin, the director out there, and I guess you could say the rest is history, but you know, it kind of started moving in a fast direction. And then she hooked me up with the mentor, and Grant Davis is his name, really great guy. And you know, it was me reaching out to him. We once we're paired with a mentor, welcome to a new life, you're given phone numbers and a one-time introduction. And then from there, Carla, at least in my experience, she let me kind of take off, and the relationship kind of blossomed. So I would call him, and we would touch base and just kind of talk about how the week was going, any concerns or issues.
One of the more challenging things in relationships is developing a strong sense of trust between different people. So the mentees have to accept the mentors and have a trusting relationship develop, and that takes time. It takes the mentor showing up when called and being responsive and helping assist the mentee in those issues and taking an active part in their life. So trust is the fundamental element that helps a mentee-mentor relationship be successful, and without it, it won't work. And so I know a lot of time is spent educating and training mentors so that they can show up in a way that their mentee needs.
When I first met Grant, my addiction was pretty well under control. So I wasn't in like the throes of addiction, and it was really relationship stuff, financial stuff, guidance with marriage and getting, you know, setting up a wedding and relationship stuff. So when I met my wife, my now wife, Dharma, I would talk to Grant a lot about issues I was having as a boyfriend or girlfriend to her, and then a fiance to her for a time.
When Wes returned to Finley, Welcome to a New Life embraced him, and we became part of his new life journey with the help of his wonderful mentor, Grant.
She encouraged weekly calls, and then that habit develops, and then friendship develops, and then, you know, we've been out, my wife and I have been out to dinner with him and his wife. I mean, it's a friendship now.
After some time, we were able to celebrate one of the biggest moments and milestones in Wes's life, his wedding.
Grant was the DJ, my mentor was the DJ at my wedding, and it's a very interesting relationship.
We are so proud of Wes and all that he's been able to accomplish thus far. We've been able to share with him the importance of community as we helped him in his new life journey. He has earned that right to live this life restored, and we are so grateful to be part of it.
The person that I mentor, I'm very proud of her. It became a mentoring me and her. And I was like, hey, you need to get a sponsor, which is somebody that helps work through the steps. And she spends more time with her sponsor doing her step work than me, which is a great thing, because until you get through the steps, you kind of stay broken. So I see her at meetings, I check up on her, but her time spent with her sponsor doing her steps, doing what she has to do to grow. And so very proud of her. If I could pass on things for people who are either interested in this program or just starting in this program, Welcome to a New Life is authentic. It's not we just want to help you to make ourselves look better. They generally care.
I finally got my license. Got a wonderful job. Made good money. Make real good money. And then to top it all off, I've got a new vehicle. Yeah. Yeah, this one right here behind me. I'm beyond, at this point in my life, I'm beyond blessed. I don't know what I did to deserve it, because I tell you the truth, I don't live every day for Jesus like I should, but I don't go around making the world a worse place to live in at the same time.
I think at the end of the day, it's a day filled with a lot more sunshine and light than there was in the past. And that makes a world of difference. I mean, if you just think about as humans, you know, during the, you know, the change of the season and, you know, the change in the amount of sunlight we have, if you will, it makes a big difference. And that's how I see these folks. They're no longer in the dark. They're not afraid to step out. And that's what we want to do. We want to make sure they're not afraid to step up. We want, you know, for that Russell to step up and talk to us. First time he's probably ever done that. Our mentorship gave him the confidence to do that. And that takes time. But once he did it, you could just feel it.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so grateful to be here today.
I mean, I could see it in his body, just like, I'm so thankful I did this. And then they become even more confident in what they need to do in life.
I really couldn't ask for more. I mean, I live in a sober house. I've got a good job, got a good vehicle. Great church people I go to church with. I can't ask for anything more. I mean, No, I can't ask for nothing more. Because I've got everything I need right now. I've got a roof over my head, I've got a vehicle, I've got my license, I've got money in my pocket. Like, what more do you need?